Yeah, today is true, is the day we remember when Jesus was passing through Jerusalem. Let's read in Luke 19. So 38 is not what we will carry on, but let's do justice of today. 37. When he comes near the place where the road goes down the Mount of Olives, the whole crowd of disciples began joyfully to praise God in loud voice for all the miracles they had seen. Hallelujah. Amen. Blessed is the King who comes in the name of the Lord. Peace in heaven and glory in the highest. Some of the Pharisees in the crowd said to Jesus, "Teacher, rebuke your disciple." Have the mercy, Lord. The people who were coming, they came to praise the Lord for the work God has done through Jesus. Then they start prophesizing, I can say, that, you know, he is the King. Blessed is the King who comes in the name of the Lord. You know, they lift him up. They cause the donkey to pass through the crowd like a king. They really prepare his way like they are welcoming him. And that was before 1 week from the king to go to the cross. Let's stop here and come back here. Let the really the men preaching is in Rome 11:29, which said the title really I wanted to focus on. Romans 11:29, which said, "For God's gift and his call are irrevocable. It cannot be changed." This is the title of what I want to share with you. God's gift and his call cannot be changed. It can't. The call of Jesus was to come to destroy the work of the devil. And the work of the devil among them was really death, sickness, and
destruction.
Everything destroy humankind. Jesus came to destroy it, so he can give us life.
Amen.
Life in abundance. Amen. Because in life in abundance, there is no sickness. That is the life we started experiencing here and after the death of this body. That is what brought him here. So he brought us second life. The first life is from our mother and our father. But this one is total life which will give us freedom and joyful and not any painful life. Because after this life, there is two lives. The one which has been assigned by Lucifer, which is distracting everyone, so he can end up with more of humankind to end up in that destruction life of eternal painful. So Jesus came to save us. He came to give us, but he can't give us that gift without calling us. And he's calling us day and night. He's calling us through our heart. I was so surprised to see some place where there is no any preaching, where God is visiting people through the angel to just to tell them there is good life after this life. They can receive Jesus. Because he came to abolish the work of the devil. So, when he called us, we accept. He gave us a gift. The calling and the gift, no one can change it. But before the call, there is always destruction. And after the call, also, there is again destruction. Until we finish what God has called us to do. Example of the call. God has called Moses from the womb. Before he came out, destruction came to kill all the babies. But because the call of God and the gift of God cannot be changed, God has called him before he go in his womb. God has called you, know me before I was in the womb of my mom.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So the mother tried to hide the baby. After 3 months, it was not easy. Remember, he took this baby in the river. The river is a place where, you know, it can come with power, it can take everything, but because the call of God is upon this man, Moses, in the basket was a bee called by trees or something which is growing in the water, until he calls the daughter of the king to see that baby. All this is, there is a destruction, but also there is connection. So Moses was also distracted by being in the king, in the king's house, in the where he's getting everything he wants, where he is going to be among the prince of Egypt, to have a good name, a good, you know, to be really famous. But because he has the call of God, he accepts after knowing who he is, after hearing the call of God, telling him, you know, hate injustice. Don't like this. It didn't come like this. He gave him to hate injustice. Sometimes you can be in a place where there is really injustice and you feel anger. You wanted to fight it. You wanted to, you know. Why? Because God is raising you to be among the righteous people, among the people, because God will reward people who don't walk with injustice, who accept a bribe, who accept, you know, that is the area where the enemy can abort your call. So he didn't refuse to hear his heart. He was fighting with injustice, but he acted in the flesh, as far as he knew how to punish somebody who is going the wrong way. So it caused him to be a wanderer, then he ended up in the desert. But again, he was very far from his people. Again, a call of God called him. Moses, Moses. He accepted the call of God. That after he was called by God, God gave him a gift. After you receive the calling of God, the second thing God gives you is a gift. And that gift is connected with humankind. The gift always is connected with humankind. When God wanted to give you answer your prayer, is answering your prayer through a humankind. It's not coming from the roof and build you a house. It's not coming from the roof and, you know, and give you a husband, give you a wife, give you babies. No. It's through people. He gives you a husband. He gives you your womb, can have a baby. He gives you, you know, because the gift God gives you is connected with humankind. So any gift you are asking God, pray God to connect you. Divine connection.
Amen.
Because the devil also likes to connect people so he can abort the gift God has planned for you. He likes to do that. Like Samson. Samson was called to rise up and bring salvation, bring really justice in his people. But he was so deceived by the prostitute. That gift was being hidden in the prison for many years until the hair started growing. But because he was called, he had to finish. He had to finish. He was called to use his gift. Because the people he killed the last minute of his life were more than the people he has killed before they took away his power, his hair. So always, when you are called, there is a hope.
Amen.
For growing the hair again.
Amen.
When you are called, just keep asking God to connect you with the one who has the gift for you.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank God for Amen. That. Remember another one. So, he was called, but because the devil wanted really to destroy him, he used him even to kill most of believers. He killed them, he killed them, but because he was called, the voice of God came on him. Jesus came visiting him. While he is killing, he said, Saul, Saul, why are you persecuting me? Why? He called him. From that time, he was blind for a few days, and Jesus told him where to go. After a few days, he was baptized, then he accepted the call of God. May whoever hear me accept the call of God before he's blind. May the one who hear me accept the call of God before he is in the womb of the fish like Jonah. God, if God calls you and you try to fight God, and God will always make sure, that is the grace of God too, to make sure even the fish will take you but will vomit you wherever he wants you to be vomited. That is the grace of God. That is what I pray for people I love. If I see them go around in the wrong place, I said, wherever you take them, but let your voice come to them.
Amen.
Call them.
Amen.
You know, I wish they can accept the call of God before they are in big trouble. They can accept the gift of God, which is eternal life. So in Revelation 3:20, they said, I stand at the door and knock. If anyone anyone hear my voice and open the door, I will come and eat with him and he with me. If anybody hear my voice. At this moment, I'm speaking. Now you are taping and you are also listening. But if you open your phone and you put the news or something, you may hear others' voice. Around here, there are many, many voices which come to confuse humankind. And these voices are going to be increased, I'm telling you. It's why we need to read the Bible, to memorize our Bible, because even the elect, if they are not careful, they can rob them the word of God. They can hear many voices. You are nothing, you can't go anywhere, you can't make it, you know. You hear many voices, but you are fighting with the word of God. You are fighting with the word of God because you have a put, hide that word of God in your heart. Because you have accepted the call of God, the devil is after you. He is after you. Look what happened to Jesus when they are saying, you know, Hosanna, Hosanna, the Son of King. They were doing that because they were praising him for the what he has done. But religious people, they didn't like it. They didn't like it. This was the sign to show what is going to happen in the future. That was not a sign. It was also a test for Jesus. He accepted this one. A test for Jesus. 1 week, people are saying, you are a king, you are mighty, you have done marvelous. After one week, they are taking all the cloth out of you. They are insulting you. They are spitting on you. They are, you know, they. That was not the will of his flesh. Where I am taking you is to differentiate God's will. Before always you get to the next level, the best things, you will pass a through trial. You will pass a true hater. People who are jealous of you, they will come, which you were not even expecting. People who are close to you, they will betray you like Judah before you are glorified. Because those things will come to abort your future, your call. To abort the gift that God has placed in you to help the nation, to help your family, to help, you know, he will come in that way. But we have to resist the devil and he will flee.
Amen.
Look at the call God had over Samuel. His mother was just a barren. What is his mother passed through? Penina every day. Insulting her, insulting, no matter how the husband was very nice to Hannah, was loving Hannah, but every day she had to be tested, you know, with Penina's children, Penina, you know, every year is giving birth, but to the place where when Hannah released her bitterness through crying in the house of God. What showed you that she was used to hear bad words is that even the priest missed out and said, oh, you drunker, you came here. And she didn't get the bitter, said, oh, you are a priest, you are a prophet, you don't know even my misery. Now you are telling me I am a drunker. But do you know what? That said, he said, oh, my Lord. It's just this sadness. It's my anguish. which is causing me to cry, to be here. Do you know? Because she responded politely. She didn't be wounded. The priest, the word the priest said, had a big effect on Hannah. Hannah had baby after leaving that place. It was because they said, may God grant you your prayer request. Do you know? That was the divine connection for Hannah. Pray everything you need in the life, which is God's plan. Not some of the things you may wish is really your flesh, is self-centered. Those kind of things, if God see, they can prevent you to make heaven. For me, I have made clear to God, I don't want anything, even these hands. If it's the hands which will prevent me to go to heaven, let these hands go. But I know heaven will be in hope. If in my leg, whatever, I don't want anything which will stop me to live with you forever. This gift of eternal life is the center of my salvation. I want to worship you, seeing you forever, forever. I want to live with you forever, forever. I want to live this world forever, forever, and be in my destiny, be in the home you went to prepare for me. That is my first prayer request, because all these things we are seeing, which are distracting us, are about to vanish. Look, this all these countries are fighting. People have to walk for many years. Some are billionaires. Some have, you know, houses, cars, family. But all of them, they are finding in the same roof, asking biscuit, asking something to wear, asking who can accommodate them. All of them, they are leaving the cars on the road. This is showing you this earth is finishing with all the desire. Humankind can desire in it. I'm not saying you can't work, you can't only work it, but please don't stop to connect with the one God has placed you in this world to be a blessing to. Because Jesus has given us a gift. We have those gifts to use for nation, to use for people. Don't keep it under your bed. Don't keep it only in your bank. Don't keep it, you know. Pray God to know, you know, who God is connecting me with. Where am I going to be? When, you know, how can I provoke God to be rejoicing? God, I'm telling you, God will speak to you. God will speak to you. And it may be painful because ourselves we are so selfish, but it will bring you more gift from above. It may bring you the gift which is required by doctors. It may give you a gift which is required by the scientists, by the economists. He may give you to invent something which, you know, why? God is bringing it there because he has seen your heart, you have humbled yourself, you accepted to be used by him fully, then he can now connect his pipe from heaven to you to be sending all this all over those who are surrounding you. Because there's a sin you have. When he was calling Samuel, he called Samuel, Samuel couldn't hear his voice. He went to the priest, Eli, three times, until he directed him to the right place, say, that is God who is speaking to you. From that time, Samuel was connected Amen. With God.
Amen.
The pipe was be open to be connected. Because he had the call of God, then the gift started coming. And the Bible said, among all the among all the people, the prophets, no one is like Samuel. Every prophecy Samuel said, nothing, everything has happened. Because he accepted the call. After the call, then he's listening. He's obeying. He's obeying. Then the gift started flowing. Because the gift grew. And he had impact in the Israel, which he put in David, who is the father of the Lord. King David is a lion, is from the line of Judah, is really a blessing to see that the priest Samuel was highly be respected more than all those kings, because everything was decreeing was happening.
Amen.
Why? Because he accepted the call of God. When you accept the call of God, the devil will discourage you. It's always me. Always is me. God is going to open doors. Because you give not because you want to be received. Of course, still illegal. But you give because you have love.
Amen.
And you know you are privileged than your neighbor. You are privileged than that person who is not waiting, who is sitting there, who is just, you know, who is not, who you are privileged than somebody who is in the hospital, has been there for a long time. You are privileged. You have, when you know that you take eyes off you, then you go there, then you give to me. Oh my, I'm telling you, I know what I'm saying is good news.
Amen.
It's good news.
Amen.
Don't be a lack. Don't have a lack in your family. Let your wife be living water. Have a, in his belly. Let your husband be living water in your belly. Let, you know, just be released. Let the freedom come. Let the freedom come. For God's gift and his call cannot be changed. It cannot be changed, but you may be called, but you may not achieve everything which God has called you to do. That it will not stop you to go to heaven. You will go to heaven, but you will not be, you know, you will not go with you have never used all the capacity God has planned to give you here on earth. So, what I can really say, let us pray God to give us the willingness to hear his voice.
Amen.
And also to obey. Not even to compare ourselves with others. Why God is calling me to do this, not my husband? Why is calling me to do this, not my sister? Why is it always me? I'm hearing this. Why? No. You are born alone, you will die alone, you will go front of God alone.